Welcome back to this video lecture series on programming questions for placement preparation. So today we'll be seeing this problem called nth magic number. So what is a magic number? This is basically a number that can be represented as a unique power of 5 or sum of unique powers of 5. So visualize it like that the first few magic numbers will be 5. So 5 itself is a unique power of 5, then 25, another unique power of 5, then 30. 30 means 5 plus 25, that is sum of 2 unique powers of 5. Like that, 125, then 130, and the series goes on. So for this problem, the task is to write the algorithm to find the nth magic number, where n will be given as input. Now if a given number n is 3, then the output should be 30, because you see in the series the first magic number 5, second 25, third 30, and like that fourth will be 125 and the fifth will be 130. So let's have a look at the approach we will be taking to write this algorithm. So we'll be taking two variables, let's say power and result, which will be initialized with 1 and 0 respectively. Then I will run a loop while the given input n is not 0. We'll start traversing the binary form of the given number from the rightmost side. Now in each iteration, we'll multiply the power with 5 and we'll check if the current binary bit is 1. If that is the case, then we'll result we will add the power to the result. Now in each loop iteration, we'll move left towards the number and by right shifting given n by 1, and after the loop termination the result will be the answer. So let's see how we can code it. So I have already written down these lines of codes here. I've taken this number n is equals to as 5. You can also take this number as given from the user, and I'll use this function find nth magic number, which takes n as the parameter to find actually the number. Okay, so let me just define it. The return type is void, and here it is. So first thing, I'm going to take this two variable, power, which will be initialized with 1, and result, which will be initialized with 0. So now I'll run a loop while n not equals to 0, or you can also write like while n. So while n is valid, that means while n is not equals to 0, what I'm going to do is power multiplied by 5. Now I'm going to check if the current bit is 1. So n logical and 1, then we add the power with the result, and what we do, we right shift the n by 1 bit. Lastly, see out the n magic number is res, and we can put an n line here like so. This is a very simple logic, so let's run this. But before running, one thing, you see if we specify n here, it will show a value of 0. So what we can do is that I can take a num and I can store it so that I can use a num here, right? So now let's run this code. So as you can see, the output is here and it says the fifth magic number is 130. So if we give let's say 3, we should be having 30 as answer, and the output shows the third or the 3th magic number is 30. So that was a very simple algorithm of how you can find the nth magic number. Thank you for watching this video and staying with us. See you next time.